Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Namaskarams to one and all present here. On behalf of Akshara Vidya Trust, I take pleasure in welcoming all of you to a talk by our Pujya Swamini on Nadopasana, mind management as a spiritual sadhana in Tyagaraja Kritis. First of all, I request Sri Ramakrishnan of Arkay Convention Center to deliver the welcome address.
Before I start welcoming, I request Pujya Swamini to occupy the seat. I request Ramakrishna Murthy, Sandeep Ramachandran, and Akshay Anantapadmanabhan also to come to the dais. Gurubhyo Namaha, Arihom. It gives me great pleasure to welcome you to yet another unique program to peep into the great heritage of Vedanta and music. This RK Convention Center has seen many legends on music and dance. Swamini Satyavratananda Saraswati gave a talk here 2 years back on Nadopasana with respect to Tyagaraja Kritis. She also inaugurated Madhura Dhwani here and blessed us. And the first year saw more than 60 concerts and 40 lecture demonstrations taking place. What else I can expect? Yes.
Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. My pranams at the lotus feet of Pujya Swamini. Today, Pujya Swamini is going to talk about mind management. Swamini has given a talk on Nadopasana in 2009 and in 2011. Now this is the third series of talk in this program. All of us know devotion is nothing but, devotion through music is called Nadopasana. Normally when we listen music, our mind become calm, quiet, joyful and peaceful because music has such capacity. Not only that, Lord Narayana himself praised music like this. Naham vasami vaikunte na yogi hradaye ravau madbhaktaha yatra gayanti tatra tishthami narada. It means, Narada, I am not in Vaikuntha, nor in the hearts of yogins, nor in sun, but where my devotees sing, there I be. That's why music is given highest place among fine arts. Swamini, our Vedanta Guru, says how music helps us as means for spiritual sadhana to attain moksha. Pujya Swamini started learning vocal at the age of 8 years and veena at the age of 13. Later, Swamini started teaching vocal and veena in Chennai in her Purvashram. Swamini studied scriptures under great acharyas, Pujya Swami Dayananda Saraswati and Pujya Swami Paramarthananda Saraswati. Then, with the blessings and guidance of Guru, Swamini started teaching scriptures at various places in Chennai nearly for the past 2 decades. The fragrance of scriptural teaching and sadhanas like Karma Yoga, Upasana Yoga and Jnana Yoga were beautifully comprised in Tyagaraja Kritis. Now Pujya Swamini going to take out the hidden meaning of those Kritis and shows us the real intention of Sri Tyagaraja Swami. Let us listen and enjoy. Sangeeta Madhuri Amrutani Manavipudu Aswadidam.
Raja Sutta Tanaya Giri Raja Sutta Tanaya Giri Raja Sutta Tanaya Sadaya Giri Raja Sutta Tanaya Sadaya Giriraja 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 Sutta Tanaya Mukachita Pada Yuga Suranatha Mukachita Pada ಕಾಲಯಮ್ಮ ಇಭ ರಾಜ ಮುಖ ಗಿರಿರಾಜ ಸುತ ತನಯ ಸರಯ ಗಿರಿರಾಜ ಸುತ ಗಣನಾಥ ಪರತ್ ಪರ ಶಂಕರ ಗಣನಾಥ ಪರತ್ ಪರ ಶಂಕರ ಗಮವಾರಿನಿಧಿ ಗಣನಾಥ ಪರತ್ ಪರ ಶಂಕರ ಗಮವಾರಿನಿಧಿ ಆಗಮವಾರಿನಿಧಿ ಆಗಮವಾರಿನಿಧಿ ಗಣನಾಥ ಪರಪರ ಶಂಕರ ಗಮವಾರಿನಿಧಿ ರಜನೀಕರ ಗಣನಾಥ ಪರಪರ ಶಂಕರ ಗಮವಾರಿನಿಧಿ ರಜನೀಕರ ಫಣಿರಾಜ ಕಂಕಣ ವಿಘ್ನ ನಿವಾರಣ ಶಾಂಭವ ಶ್ರೀ ಫಣಿರಾಜ ಕಂಕಣ ವಿಘ್ನ ನಿವಾರಣ ಶಾಂಭವ ಶ್ರೀ ತ್ಯಾಗರಾಜ ನೂತ ಫಣಿರಾಜ ಕಂಕಣ ವಿಘ್ನ ನಿವಾರಣ ಶಾಂಭವ ಶ್ರೀ ತ್ಯಾಗರಾಜ ನೂತ ಗಿರಿರಾಜ ಸುತ ತನಯ ಸರಯ ಗಿರಿರಾಜ ಸುತ ತನಯ
ಸದಾಶಿವಸಮಾರಂಭಾಂ ಶಂಕರಾಚಾರ್ಯಮಧ್ಯಮಾಂ ಅಸ್ಮದಾಚಾರ್ಯಪರ್ಯಂತಾಂ ವಂದೇ ಗುರುಪರಂಪರಾಂ. ಓಂ ನಾದೋಪಾಸನ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಉಪಾಸನ ಆನ್ ನಾದ. ನಾದ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಎ ಸೌಂಡ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಪ್ರೈಮರಿ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್. ಲಿಟ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ನಾದ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಎ ಸೌಂಡ್, ಎ ಶಬ್ದ. But its implied meaning is Brahman. Nada Upasana means Brahma Upasana. Once you take Shabda, Shabda Brahma alone is Nada Brahma. Nada means sound, Shabda. Since Nada is known as Brahman, Nada Upasana means Brahma Upasana. Therefore, we call Shabda Brahma. Shabdam Brahma Ucchate. Shabdam itself is another name for Brahman. Shabdam and Brahman are not different. Upasana means upas is a verbal form to sit near to sit side to what? Upas means to sit near. To sit near to what? Nada. To sit near to Brahman. Nada means Brahman. To sit near to Brahman. Who is this Brahman? How can I sit near Brahman? Brahman has got two aspects. Sakara Brahma and Nirakara Brahma. Sakara means formed Brahman, Brahman with a form, Brahman with an attribute, Saguna Brahma, Sakaram Brahma. A formed Brahman, an attributed Brahman, who is known as Ishvara. Another aspect of Brahman is Nirakara Brahman, Brahman without forms, Brahman without attributes, Nirgunam Brahma, Nirakaram Brahma. So two aspects are there for Brahman. Now, to sit near to Upasana, whether I have to sit near Sakara Brahman or Nirakara Brahman, question comes. Since Brahman has got two aspects, Tyagaraja, Saint Tyagaraja has chosen Sakara Brahman, Saguna Brahma, Ishvara, in the name of Lord Rama. Why Lord Rama only chosen by Tyagaraja? Why not Nirakara Brahman? Nirakara Brahman is all pervading, formless, you cannot sit nearby. Therefore, Saint Tyagaraja took that formed Brahman, Ishvara, in the name of Lord Rama. The next question, Nada is Brahman, Upasana means sit nearby. Sit nearby means physically sitting near. Upasana means it's a mental activity. It is not a physical activity. Upasana means it is a manasa vyapara, mental activity. So there also you should not take again literal meaning. You have to take secondary meaning. What it means, upasana means your mind has to abide. Your mind has to filled with that Nada Brahma. Manasa Vyapara. It is not physically sitting nearby. That is only karma. Kaika karma. Upasana is not a physical activity. Therefore, Nada Upasana means Brahma Upasana. Brahma Upasana means Sakara Brahma Upasana. Sakara Brahma Upasana means Ishvara Upasana. That Ishvara Upasana is taken in different names by different bhaktas. Mirabai took that Ishvara in Krishna form. Purandaradasa took that Ishvara form in Vithala form. Shyama Shastri took that form in a Devi form. So different bhaktas took one Ishvara in different names. That is the meaning of Upasana, not sitting nearby physically. Manasika Vyaparaha. So Nadopasana. Now let us come to the next, mind management. What is mind? Where is mind? Where is mind? Mind is in brain, they say. Scientist says, mind is in brain. Shastra says, mind is not in brain. Mind is in your heart. Which heart, right side or left side? All questions, only doubts we have. The mind, which is only left side, wherever you have physical heart, there itself mind is there. What is the nature of mind? A mind is that in which thoughts arise, emotions, feelings, positive thoughts, negative thoughts arise in the mind. negative and positive thoughts when they arise, you never plan what thought next to come. You never plan. It happens. Thought arise without your will, without your plan. Emotions arise. Love, compassion, forgiveness, respect, admiration. So many feelings rise in your own mind. When that mind is your friend, it is a spiritually friendly mind. Lord Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, Uddharet Atmana Atmanam. May you uplift yourself by yourself. You need not go to counselors. Indirectly, Lord Krishna hinting us. Uddharet Atmana Atmanam. There, Atma means not self. Atma means mind. May you uplift your mind with your mind. May you uplift your negative mind, problematic mind, with a positive, non-problematic mind. May you uplift yourself. There is no other way. Mind management. Just like time management, money management. Everyone talks about management nowadays. Then I also started, why not me? So mind management. Time management, money management are included in mind management. Without mind management, money management, time management is not possible. Therefore, Tyagaraja, all our ancestors never talk about money management or time management. Have you heard? Never. They only focus on their mind. How to manage my mind? Why this management? That word itself is there is a lot of hidden meaning. Management means it is not in your control. Time management, time is not in your control. Unpredictable, what happens, at what time you do not know. Unsustainable, unpredictable. It goes haywire. What we think, what we plan, sometimes it goes in a different way. Time management, I manage, somehow I manage. Similarly, money also, when it comes, when it goes, we do not know. I am managing. That is why people, when you ask, I am managing. I am managing. That's why he is called manager. Managing. Like that, mind also, we have to learn how to manage. You cannot change the mind totally. 100% perfect mind doesn't exist. We convert the negative mind, vulnerable mind, into a positive, healthy, right, directed, well-disciplined mind. We want to channelize. This is called management. Who is the master of this mind management except Tyagaraja? Who is there? So Tyagaraja is focusing on mind management excellently. As tradition brings, same way he brings in every kirtana. Amazing. His way of expression, how one has to handle the mind. So, mind management. Then what is this spiritual sadhana? This is my title, what I am talking. This is the title what I have given. Spiritual sadhana. What do you mean by spiritual? Spiritual means spirit, Atma. Spiritual means that which is connected to Atma, the Self, spiritual. Sadhana means a means. A means through which I attain the ultimate moksha. So mind management is a spiritual sadhana, not any other sadhana. It is a spiritual sadhana to attain the ultimate purushartha, that is moksha. Moksha can be attained only through the mind management. Because mind alone helps us to discover, to recognize my real nature. Which mind can help us? A mind that which has got daivi sampat. All virtues. A mind is a healthy mind, relaxed mind, calm mind, steady mind, cheerful mind. All these virtues, if that mind has got, it helps you to recognize your true nature by knowing which you are free from sorrow. Therefore, we want to get moksha, freedom from sorrow, we have to take the spiritual sadhana, that is mind management, through Nadopasana under the guidance of Tyagaraja Swami. Okay? Tyagaraja gives address his mind. Oh mind, he requests his mind. Sometimes it's pleading also, requesting, pleading, advising his own mind. This is called appointment with yourself. We take appointment with all people, except with our mind. But Tyagaraja intelligently took appointment with his own mind, addressing his own mind by taking Nada Brahma through music. He is addressing the Lord, talking to his mind, oh mind, be like this. Don't be like that. Be like this, then only you attain that Brahmananda, Parama Ananda. Sangeeta is that with the devotion you have to sing. Without Sangeeta Jnanam, Sangeeta Jnanam is there, but no bhakti suppose. Bhakti vina, without bhakti, sanmargam kalade, is there right way? Sanmargan means moksha marga. Is there moksha marga? If anyone sings hours together for Guinness book record, they are singing. Can moksha is possible for such a singer without devotion once they sing? Tyagaraja addressing his mind. Now we listen from our Ramakrishna Murthy in Dhanyasi Raga, Sangeeta Jnanam.
Sangeeta Jnanam Bhakti Vina, 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 Sangeeta Jnanam Bhakti vina sanmargam galade manasa sangeeta.
క్వశ్చన్ సంగీత జ్ఞానము భక్తి వినా సన్మార్గము గలదే మనసా ఎరుజును ఈజ్ టెల్లింగ్ దట్ నాట్ క్వశ్చనింగ్ ఆక్షేపార్థే నత ప్రశ్నార్థే ఐ యూస్ సమ్ వేదాంతిక్ టర్మ్స్ బికాస్ మెనీ వేదాంతిక్ స్టూడెంట్స్ ఆర్ హియర్ అదర్స్ క్యాన్ ఇగ్నోర్ దోస్ వర్డ్స్ ఓకే హూ ఆర్ దే దోస్ భక్తాస్ సాంగ్ ఆల్ ద కీర్తనాస్ విత్ భక్తి Who are they? Bhrungi Natesha. All these bhaktas. Bhrungi Natesha. Samira means Vayuputra Anjaneya. Ghataja Agastya. Matanga Naradadi. They sang every kirtana music rendering by bhakti. One has to sing like that. So Tyagaraja is telling to all singers, we also become like this. Indirectly telling. For all of us also, not only singers, you are also singers at home, okay? Then he says, Nyaya Anyayamulu Telusunu Jagamulu. I know very well, oh mind, what is proper, Nyaya, Anyaya, what is improper, what is right, what is wrong, Nyaya Anyayamulu Telusunu Jagamulu in this world. What I know, you know, mind is Maya. Maya Mayamani. This whole world is నథింగ్ బట్ మాయామయం, మేడ్ అవుట్ ఆఫ్ మాయా, మాయామయమని తెలుసు. నాట్ ఓన్లీ దట్, ఇన్ దిస్ వరల్డ్ లాట్ ఆఫ్ దుర్గుణాస్ ఆర్ ఆల్సో దేర్. దుర్గుణ కాయజాది షడ్రిపుల జయించు, దట్ షడ్రిపులు మీన్స్ సిక్స్ ఎనిమీస్ వై హ్యావ్ కామ క్రోధ మోహ మదమాత్సర్యాది షడ్రిపీస్ సిక్స్ ఎనిమీస్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు కాంకర్ దెమ్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు కాంకర్ దెమ్ కార్యము తెలుసును. త్యాగరాజ నోస్ హౌ టు హ్యాండిల్ కామ క్రోధ లోభ మోహ మదమాత్సర్యాది. సో హీ సేస్ దుర్గుణములు కాయజాతి షడ్రూపుల జయించు, దట్ జయించు ఈజ్ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్. వన్ హ్యాస్ టు కాంకర్ దేర్ ఓన్ మైండ్. దెర్ ఆర్ సిక్స్ ఎనిమీస్, ఇన్నర్ ఎనిమీస్, వన్ హ్యాస్ టు కాంకర్ టు డెవలప్ డివోషన్. దెన్ ఓన్లీ వీ కెన్ హ్యావ్ ద డివోషన్ అండ్ ద భక్తి వెన్ యూ సింగ్ లార్డ్ కమ్స్ హియర్ టు ఆర్కే సెంటర్ టుడే. Now we see how Tyagaraja requesting his own mind, please accept my manavi alakincharadate. Manavi means what? My request. I'm pleading you, please listen to me, oh mind. You listen to me, whatever I say is good for you. Like that you also, that means we are also, look at our own mind as our own friend. So Tyagaraja handled that mind as a friend, is asking in Nadina Kanti Raga. Now we listen.
Ramachandruni karunantaranga
చారులై దాసి చింతగా కర్మకాండ మాత కృష్ణులై భవ గగన చారులై దాసి చింతగా కన్ని మానవ
In Sangeeta Jnanamu, that Kirtana, Tyagaraja criticized the Shushka Sangeeta. Sadbhakti Sangeeta Prashamsa and Shushka Sangeeta Garhanam did in the previous Kirtana. Now in this Kirtana, Tyagaraja condemned Karmakanda. Manavi alakincharadati, O mind, listen to my request. I can tell you what are all the secrets of mind. Marma mella delipedane. Marma means all secrets. I will tell you how this mind attracts to rituals. Ganudaina Ramachandruni Karunanta Rangamuna. I know Rama's heart, very compassionate. Karunantarangam. Karuna, full of Karuna, compassion. I know, may you listen to me. This is the secret. My Rama is so compassionate. Oh mind, listen to me. Why Rama took avatara? You know, he's telling to his mind, not to us. He's talking to his own mind. He says, Rama took avatara. He lived and showed to the universe. Nadata. Nadata means what? He lived. This is the way one has to live. He showed us. That's why we have to live as Rama lived. We have to follow, do what Krishna said. We have to do what Krishna said. We have to live as Rama lived. Nadata. Kanipinchinadi, he appeared. How? He appeared as Manavavatarudai. In Manavavataram, Manushya Janma, he appeared. Ordinary person-like, he appeared. For whose sake he appeared? To show, oh human beings, I am also born like a human being only. This is the way you have to live. Why he has to show? Because people are spending their time fully in karma kanda. Karma kanda mata akrishtulai. This ritual and that ritual go on doing without any internal refinement. That is why karma kanda akrishtulai. Then what? Bhava gahana charulai. They are in samsara. They are perpetuating their samsara punarapi janaram punarapi maranam. Bhava means a samsara. ஜனன மரண சம்சாரா தேர் கண்டினியூயிங் பவ கஹன சாரு லைக் கஹன மீன்ஸ் வெரி டீப் தட்ஸ் வை கர்மகாண்டா இஸ் ஸோ வாஸ்ட் இஃப் யூ கோ இன் டு தட் ரிச்சுவல்ஸ் யூ கெனாட் கம் அவுட் தட் ரிச்சுவல்ஸ் கெப்ட் டு ரிஃபைன் அவர் மைண்ட் யூ ஷுட் நாட் பிகம் அப்சஸ்ட் வித் தட் ரிச்சுவல்ஸ் rituals are meant rituals are compulsory pooja vratam nomu everything is compulsory but until it refine your mind you should not become obsessed by those rituals it should not become sentimental it should not become mechanical every karma should be meaningful once you refine your mind then that karma kanda job is over to make you rajasic from tamasic The karmakanda rituals are kept. Otherwise, we will become lazy. If Dhanurmasa music season is not there, people will sleep at home. That's why they keep kacheri at 6 o'clock. Like that, our Ramakrishna kept an akhanda namam on Shivaratri day. Otherwise, they will see what TV programs. Therefore, some program must be there, rituals must be there, so that we can be active. From tamasic laziness we can come out. That is why he said, I took Manava Avatara to show, that's why Rama taught Rama Gita is there, he taught Lakshmana. What is moksha? How to attain moksha? So Rama, he is very compassionate and he showed his life, the path, how one has to live. Therefore, my mind, please listen to me. Next, Kirtana. We are going to hear that Nama Mahatmyam, how a Nama, Bhagavan's name and its glory. Tyagaraja is going to give in Purna Chandrika Raga. All beautiful kirtanas, now he will take up.
తెలిసి రామ చింతనతో నామము తెలిసి రామ చింతనతో నామము తెలిసి రామ చింతనతో నామము తెలిసి రామ చింతనతో నామము Thank you. chapala khula peru ramayani chapala khula peru kamadula poru varu iru kamadula poru varu iru ramayani brahmamunagu peru ramayani brahmamunaku peru ramayani brahmamunaku peru aa manava jananaarthulu thiru aa manava jananaarthulu thiru aa manava jananaarthulu thiru tellisi ramachintanato namamu అర్కమనుచు జిల్లేడు తరు పేరు అర్కమనుచు జిల్లేడు తరు పేరు మగట బూధులేటీరు అర్కమనుచు జిల్లేడు తరు పేరు మగట బూధులేటీరు అర్కుటనుచు భాస్కరునికి పేరు వర్కుడను భాస్కరునికి పేరు వర్కుడను చు భాస్కరునికి పేరు కుటకమను అంధకారము దేవు కుటకమను అంధకారము దేవు తెలిసి రామ చింతనతో నామము చేయవే ఓ మనస అజమనుచు మేషమునకు పేరు అజమనుచు మేషమునకు పేరు నిజ కోరికలే లగిరేరు అజమనుషు మేషమునకు పేరు నిజ కోరికలే లగిరేరు అజుడని వాగీశ్వరునికి పేరు అజుడని వాగీశ్వరునికి పేరు అజుడని వాగీశ్వరునికి పేరు విజయముగల్ గును త్యాగరాజ వినోతును విజయముగల్ గును త్యాగరాజ వినోతును రామ చింతనతో నమము సేయవే ఓ మనస
తెలసి రామ చింతనతో తెలసి మీన్స్ బై నోయింగ్ ఇట్స్ మీనింగ్ యు హ్యావ్ టు చింతన యు హ్యావ్ టు డూ చింతన థింకింగ్ అబౌట్ లార్డ్ రామ బై నోయింగ్ ఇట్స్ మీనింగ్ ఇఫ్ యు డూ నాట్ నో ద మీనింగ్ అండ్ యు చాంట్ ఇట్ గివ్స్ అనదర్ రిజల్ట్ దేర్ ఫోర్ బెటర్ టు నో ద మీనింగ్ ఆల్సో వాట్ యు ఆర్ చాంటింగ్ దేర్ ఫోర్ త్యాగరాజ ఈజ్ అన్ ఎగ్జాంపులరీ in propagating the nama japa mantra japa is very very efficacious one has to take up mantra bhagwan nama and chant it protects mananat trayate iti mantrah mantra japa or nama japa is very efficacious jakaro janma vichhedah pakara papanashanaha janma papa haro yasmat japa iti uchyate rama japa Tyagaraja took by chanting Bhagavan's name we can come out of janma and papa telasi rama chintanadu how talapulanni nilipi nimishamaina I am not asking you half an hour or 1 hour nimishamaina even 1 minute nimisha means 1 minute nimishamaina taraka roopuni nija tattvamunu telasi rama chintana you have to know the nija tattva means what the true nature of that rama atma rama true nature of rama is not dasharatha rama or kausalya rama sita rama but true nature of rama nija tattvam is brahma tattvam You have to chant talapulanni. Talapulanni means all other thoughts. You please keep aside. After the, sometime you can take up, but at least at that japa time you keep them aside. Taraka Rupuni. What a beautiful name. Taraka Rupuni. Rama is of the form of by chanting whose name Taraka means Tarayati iti Taraka mantram. That life, you know, Janana Marana you cross over. Taraka means what? Tarayati iti Tarakam. In another Kirtana, Tyagaraja sings, Rama namamu janma rakshaka mantram. Panamu seyave o manasa. It is janma rakshaka mantram. What about other mantras? That is our problem. All mantras are efficacious for Rama. Rama is the Ishta Devata of Tyagaraja. So all mantras are also good. You can take up any nama, Taraka Rupani. నిజతత్వమును తెలిసి నిజతత్వమును తెలిసి దట్ ఈస్ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్ అండర్లైన్ దేర్ దెన్ హీ బ్రింగ్స్ చరణంస్ రామ అని చపలాక్షుల పేరు రామ హ్యాస్ గాట్ టూ మీనింగ్స్ ఓ మైండ్ ఈజ్ నాట్ అడ్రస్సింగ్ ఎనీ ఆడియన్స్ ఈజ్ అడ్రస్సింగ్ సిట్టింగ్ అలోన్ అడ్రస్సింగ్ హిజ్ ఓన్ మైండ్ వట్ ఎ పెక్యులియర్ వే ఆఫ్ అప్రోచింగ్ హిజ్ మైండ్ Rama is a name for a woman. And Rama is the name for Brahman also. Now if you think Rama, Rama, Rama is like a woman, your lust will increase more and more. Your desires can never be satiated. But you know the meaning of Rama as Brahman, it is a Taraka mantra. If you don't know the meaning of Rama as Brahman and you take it as a woman, your samsara increases. See the difference. May you know the meaning. Then in second charanam, he says, Arka. Arka means, it has got two meanings. Arka means that jillidupu in Telugu we call it is a poisonous. It is a poisonous. If you go on chanting Arka, 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 how can you stop the monkey mind? This monkey mind is a wandering mind. By knowing that Arka as Jilledupu, that poisonous flower, if you go on thinking that, you are not going to come out of this samsara. But you remember the Arka as Suryaha, Surya Vamsya Jataha Rama. Suryaha, if you remember, that Rama will protect you. That Arka will protect you, Surya Bhagavan will protect you. Then he removes your Kutarka. That's what he says. If you know that Arka as Rama, he removes your Kutarka means, what is Kutarka? Illogical arguments, all. You can stop those arguments. Kutarka, you come out. Then last charanam he says, Aja also has got two meanings. Those who know Sanskrit, they can revel. Ajaha is a goat, no? It is one name. Ajaha means goat. If you go on chanting Aja, Aja, Aja means what is the use of that? You cannot come out of your vicious cycle of samsara. But if you know the Aja, birthless Brahman, you can cross over samsara. Therefore, better know the meaning always. Mantra also, when you are chanting, you should know the meaning. Panchakshari or Ashtakshari, any mantra, we have to know the meaning and then do japa, nama japa. Telasi Rama Chintanato. Then only it will give full benefit. That's why mantra japa is very, very efficacious. Now, we are going to listen next Kirtana suspense. Okay.
Manasunilpa shakti leka pote madhura kantha virula pooje mije unu manasunilpa shakti leka pote madhura kantha virula pooje mije unu manasunilpa shakti leka pote madhura kantha virula pooje mije unu manasunilpa shakti leka pote madhura kantha virula pooje mije unu manasunilpa shakti leka pote ta munigide ghanadur madudaita munigide ghanadur madudaita munigide ghanadur madudaita munigide ghanadur madudaita munigide ghanadur sugandra korite somayaji swarga gudauno somitamma soga sugandra korite somayaji swarga gudauno somitamma soga sugandra korite somayaji swarga gudauno Tyagaraja Kritis, manasunilpa shakti leka pote విరుల పూజె మిజేయు మనసు నిల్ప శక్తి లేక పోచే.
Mind, manasu, is very important. We have to handle. Uddharet atmana, I said. A controlled, disciplined mind. Manasu nilpa shakti. Shakti means a capacity. Nilpa shakti, to stop the mind. Here stop means not totally stopping the mind, but channelizing the mind. You have to channelize the mind, direct the mind into a right direction. If that shakti you do not have, what is the use of performing any puja with a lot of flowers and a lot of abhisheka dravyams and a lot of attahasam, we say, and keeping everything in front of you. But you are doing puja, your mind is somewhere. You are here, but you don't have that presence of mind. Mind is somewhere. Manasu nilpa shakti lekapote. Madhura ganta virula. The puja with so many items. Emi jethunu, what can I do? Oh mind, please stay one place so that I want to worship my Rama. So I want to focus on him. Don't go here and there. My brother will shout to you all the time. Don't mind. You know, Ra, Tyagaraja's brother, is always shouting. But don't bother about it. You focus on Rama. If I don't have that shakti, if I don't stop my mind at that time, puja time, what is the use of puja? How Rama can bless me? Then he asks, if any person does puja or abhishekam, ghanadurmatudai, people go here and there and take bath, Kaveri, near to him only Kaveri, that's why he's addressing Kaveri. Ghanadurmatudai ta munigite, taking dip in the Kaveri, Ganges. Kaveri, Mandakini, Mandakini means Ganga. If a person, ghanadurmatudai, taking dip in the water. What is the use? Ghanadurmatudai means with arrogance, pride. I am great, I am wonderful. He wants all admirations from others, never admire others. You do not know how to admire others. But he wants always appreciation from others. That is called ghanadurmati. Arrogance, pride, show, everything, pomp and show. No vinayam at all. No amanitvam, adambhitvam, no humility. Suppose ghanadurmatadai with arrogance, with a stiff neck, anartham. So that person, ghanadurmatudai, ta munigite, when he dips in that water, Haridwar, he is dipping. Every time he goes to there and take dip in that Ganga and Kaveri. Everywhere, Godavari, Krishna, so many rivers are meant for what? To purify us. Why we take bath in the rivers? To purify us. If your mind is not having humility, that submission, the reverence, and you are having a lot of arrogance, if you dip also, Kaveri cannot do anything. Kaveri is helpless. Even Ganga is helpless. She cannot remove your papam. Because when taking bath also, you are like this. Oh mind, give up. Give up that ahankara. Give up that ahankara, ego. Then he says, next charanam, Ardhangi, wife, is one who helps husband in a dharmic way. So, Ardha Angi Dharma Patni. If Dharma Patni, if she is not Dharma Patni and asking him come to cinema, come to there, here and we go, not helping him in a dharmic way, this Somayaji can get Swarga. That Somidamma is the wife of Somayaji. Okay, Swami Dhamma wants sense pleasures, suppose. If she is not a dharmapatni, if she is not a arthangi as a dharmapatni, what Somayaji can do? He is also helpless. He cannot get swarga. Swarga arhuda avuna? Can he get that permission in swarga? Therefore, wife also must be responsible. Both of them live together a dharmic life. That is very important. Not by doing any rituals alone. As I am performing rituals, I have to develop my refinement, mental refinement. I have to check my mind. Then he says, Kama krodha tapam vanarchite. Kama and krodha are doing tapas. This person sitting and doing tapas after Kaveri bath, what he does in a japa? Comes to the bank and doing tapas. What type of person with full of kama and krodha? Like Hiranyakashipu, Hiranyaksha, Shumbha, Nishumbha, Ravana, Kumbhakarna, Dantravaktra, Shishupala, all twins, brothers. Kama, krodha. Obstructed kama alone comes as krodha. Krodha is in hidden form in kama. Kama and krodha both come together. Kama is smiling villain. Krodha is a frowning villain. Therefore, we have to be very careful. Kama is called attachment. Raga is called kama. Dvesha, krodha comes because of dvesha, aversion. This kama, krodha are compared or symbolized in our Puranas like Hiranyakashipu, Hiranyaksha. We think Hiranyakashipu, Hiranyaksha somewhere. They are not outside. They are here only. Kama krodhudu tapam vanarchite. If he does, Ravana did tapas. Ravana did tapas. Hiranyakashipu did tapas. What is the use? What is their lot? What happened to Ravana? What happened to Hiranyakashipu? With desire, with lust, and with anger, with aversion. And with all this, if you do tapas, no use. Therefore, you have to do tapas in such a way, with humility, without any ahankara. Hiranyakashipu said, "Hey, Prahlada, I am the Lord. You repeat my name, not Lord Narayana's name." This is the suggestion given to his own son, Hiranyakashipu. Therefore, they all did tapas. But they are all come under asuras. Even though Ravana born as a Brahmana, we consider him asura because of his asura guna. Therefore, how one can get moksha, if he performs all this, kama, krodha, tapam, vanarchite, gachi, rakshinchuno, can Rama protect such a person? Krishna could not protect Duryodhana. Rama could not protect Ravana. Iniki poi naaliki va ani chunnaru Ramar. In Kambaramayanam, he says, iniki poi naaliki va. Lakshmana was so angry. Why? Whenever Ravana is coming, Rama is leaving. No? At least he will change his mind by tomorrow. No change at all. Gachi rakshinchono, can Rama protect him? But whereas Rama protected Vibhishana. Vibhishana also born in the same asura family. How Bhagavan protected him? Because he has changed. He has changed his party, like our political parties. People are changing. He has changed his party, but he has changed to a right party. Okay, that is important. That is very important. Your satsangatyam is very important. Satsangatyam, once he comes to Rama's side, how we are worshipping Vibhishana as a pratasmaraniya. His own brother Ravana, what happened? Therefore, that kama krodha, the most culprits, Lord Krishna says, tau hyasya paripanthi nau. Tayorna vasham na agachet. Oh Arjuna, may you not succumb to them, your kama and krodha. Please control them. Never have such illegitimate desires and never have such anger, shouting, hitting others, blaming, criticizing. This type of habit, how to drop? He's addressing his own mind. Manasu nilpa sikti lekapote. Why? Because of anger, short-temperedness, he cannot control his mind. Because of over desires, he cannot control his mind. So kama, krodha are the main culprits, leads to moha, mada, masarya. Kama, krodhascha, lobhascha, dehe tishtanti taskaraha, jnana ratnapaharaya, tasmat jagrata jagrata. May you be careful, six enemies are sitting inside you. Kama, krodha are there, other enemies easily can come inside. So handle your kama, krodha. In this kirtana, Tyagaraja condemned those people who does rituals with a lot of kama and krodha. And that's why your Puranas are beautifully picturized. When you study their stories, characters, you understand how great bhaktas with vinayam, reverence, bhakti, lot of submission they have attained the Lord. Whereas these people also did tapas. Ravana did tapas, Hiranyakashipu did tapas. But where are they? So we have to see the difference between them. So kama krodha to be reduced. Not totally at a time, not possible. Slowly, gradually we have to come out of kama and krodha. They are your enemies, Lord Krishna says. Then Arjuna asked, how to control? I am not able to control my mind. It is very, very difficult. Who said it is easy? Who said it is easy? We have never said it is easy. It is very, very difficult to control the mind. Abhyasena tu kaunteya vairagyena cha grihyate. By abhyasa you can control. By practice only. At the age of 70, person says, I am short-tempered. So what? That's my nature. He says like that. What to do with that person? That lady really pavam. She suffers. We are not supposed to say like that. So we have to very, 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 very carefully handle our own raga, dvesha, kama, krodha. Not only we are disturbing that environment in the family and the society, it is harmful to us for our own spiritual upliftment. Therefore, illegitimate, immoderate desires will lead to krodha. Obstructed desires will lead to krodha. Krodha means dhyayato vishayan pumsaha sangasteshu pajayate sangasanjayate kamaha kama krodho vijayate krodhat bhavati sammohaha sammoha smriti vibhramaha. Go on, that sloka. Pranashyati. Until last, he will not come up like a clay ball. No? He cannot come up in his life. That's why these kirtanas, through this we have to learn a lot. We have to change our character. We have to change our personality from negative to positive. Now we are going to hear the next shloka. Raga Sudharasa Andolika. A beautiful kirtana. We'll listen.
Raga Sudha Rasa, Raga Sudha Rasa, Raga Sudha Rasa, Panamu Jesi, Raga Sudha Rasa, Panamu
Mm-hmm.
ஓ மனசா ரஞ்சில்லவே, மே யூ என்ஜாய். என்னுடைய ஜாய், சுவாமி பரமார்த்தானந்த சேஸ், என்னுடைய ஜாய் என்ஜாய், ரஞ்சில்லவே மே யூ என்ஜாய், ரெவல் ரஞ்சில்லவே. ஓ மனசா, இன் வாட்? நாட் எனிவேர். வேர்? ராக சுதாரச, சுதா அமிர்தம், raga sudha, you have to enjoy that raga, the music. It is amritam. The music is our sadhana for moksha. Music is not meant for just for entertainment. Artha kama purushartha, by learning music you may get money, you may have entertainment. They are all only secondary byproducts. The primary product of, primary benefit of music is moksha. Dharma purushartha and moksha purushartha. Music meant for that. We are so fortunate in Chennai, in Dharun Masa, music season, from all over the world, people are coming here. How many people are sanctifying their mind, purifying their mind, that music. It cultivates, it refines the mind, knowingly, unknowingly. If you are in that classical music, it does samskara, refines your personality. That music has got such a power. Therefore, O mind, raga sudharasa, ranjillavi, may you enjoy all the time. Wherever music program is there, you can go there. That to Mailapur. There are Tinagar, Mailapur, people are really lovers of music. Now, I hope you know, in Chennai, all over, people are having that. So, in Chennai, Tyagaraja knows, in Chennai, people are going to enjoy Raga Sudharasa, Panamu Jesi, drink. How can you drink Panam? How can you drink Raga Sudha? You drink, that's what. Without drinking, you drink, that's all. Raga Sudha Amritam. Sudha means Amritam, nectar. By drinking that Raga Amritam, you get Amritatvam. how you get amrutattvam in charanam, Anupallavi, he says, yaga yoga tyaga bhoga phalamula sange. It gives the phalam of yaga. Yaga phalam is what? Swarga. If you go on singing music or you attend music season, you go to swarga. Yaga phalam it gives. By performing yagas, you go to swarga according to scriptures. If you listen to Ramakrishna Murthy's program, you go to swarga. You need not do any yaga. Yaga. Yoga, ashtanga yoga, pranayama, dharana, dhyana, samadhi. By doing that, what benefit you get by coming to ERK center, you will get. Any other music program, anywhere, every singer, whenever they are singing the classical music, it is a divine. The divine. It is divine. They are sitting Shruti and Mata and Pita Laya. Both are sitting. Veda Mata is sitting in the middle. No? Shruti, Mata, Laya, Pita, Mridangam and violin. Shruti is going on. See that Veda, Samaganam is coming out. What is the song you think? Song is nothing but Samaganam. All Saptaswaras have come from only Vedas. Therefore, he says, yaga phalam, yoga phalam. Yoga phalam, by that you go to Brahmaloka, by upasana ityarthaha. Yoga means upasana. By performing nishkama upasana, one can go to Brahmaloka. So you go to Swargaloka. If you listen to music, you enjoy, you go to Brahmaloka. If you do upasana with sakamataya, you go to Brahmaloka and come back. If you do nishkamataya, this is what yoga, upasana, you go and stay there. How long? Until you get kramamukti. See how Shastra is brought here beautifully. When I was learning young age, I do not know these meanings. Later only I come to know. So, Swargaloka phalam is possible through music. Brahmaloka phalam is also possible. Next what? Tyaga. Tyage naike amrutatvamanashuhu. Moksha phalam. Jivan mukti. Sadhyo mukti is also possible. What not? Everything is possible. You want to go to Swarga, you can go. You want to go to Brahmaloka, you can go. You want to get here now itself mukti, jivan mukti, liberation you can get. All in one. Three in one. Three in one. Yaga, yoga, tyaga gives Swarga and Brahmaloka and Sadhya Mukti. Which one you want? You have to decide. Okay. Then Charana, he brings Mandukyopanishad. Beautifully, Sadashiva Mayamagu Nadonkara Swara. Whoever knows Mandukyopanishad, then artham. Akara, Ukara, Makara, Onkara is nothing but Shantam, Shivam, Advaitam, Chaturtham, Manyantesa, Atmasa, Vigneyaha. To understand the Tyagaraja Kritis, you require Upanishadic Jnanam. Yes, true, no? This is true. He is telling, Sada Shiva Mayamagu Nada Onkaram. Onkara is nothing but Sadashiva Mayam. Lord Shiva, Turiya Atma, Onkara Mayam, Akara, Ukara, Makara, Vidulu Jivan Muktulu. Those who knows, Vidulu means what? Those who knows. The knowers of that Sadashiva, who is the Turiya Atma, who is the manifestation of Nada Onkara, whoever knows that. Pradhamah Pada, Dvitiyah Pada, Tritiyah Pada, Karyapada, Karanapada, whoever knows. Vidulu, they are all knowers. Mandukya Upanishadic students. I didn't say, he is telling. Okay. Vidulu Jivan Muktulu, they are liberated. Vidulu Jivan Muktulani, Tyagaraja Tiliyu. Tyagaraja Tilisu. He knows what. Those are the liberated people who knows Lord Shiva as the Swara, as the Raga, as the Omkara, none other than Shiva. We only separate. We the unintelligent human beings separate. Raga is different, Swara is different, Omkara is different, Shiva is different. For a mature mind, refined mind people, nothing is separate from God. Nothing is separate from God. That is why in our Hindu culture we have that vision, attitude, seeing everything as Bhagavan. How beautifully he brought Mandukya Upanishad here in this Sadashiva Mayamagu. Mayamagu means filled with, full of Nada Omkara Swara. Nada Omkara Swara. Nada Brahmam. Omkara Swaram. Vidula Jivan Muktulu. They are the liberated while living here itself. Who says, I know, Tyagaraja says, I know. Therefore, oh mind, you also must do what? Raga Sudha Rasa, enjoy. Panamu Jesi, Ranjillave. Because if you want, you can take me to Swarga, or you can take me to what? Brahmaloka, or you can give me Jivan Mukti. Please listen my words, he's asking. Oh Manasa, please listen to me. Sangeeta is having such yaga phalam, yoga phalam, tyaga phalam. Even sannyasi, if you won't become a sannyasi, tyaga means a sannyasa. You need not become a sannyasi. You can go to music season, slowly you will become a sannyasi. Internal sannyasa. Internal sannyasa means you become a real devotee, worshipper of Lord, and your whole vision change towards your life, and you see the Lord everywhere. Tyagaraja is bringing such a devotion in us through his lyrics. What a bhava, what a meaning is there. Whole Upanishadic, Vedantic teaching I am seeing here. Now let us go to the next Kirtana. He is addressing again mind. All are addressing his own mind. Manasa etulortune malayamartham. A naughty mind is coming now. In spite of addressing many times, it is not listening. Now he is requesting.
Shaduni,
Gentle breeze. So, Malaya Marutha means a gentle breeze, the raga name. Just as when a mother has got a naughty child going here and there, not listening, hyperactive child, no, sometimes they won't listen. They move here and there, then mother has to please, vada kanna, like that they call, no, in Tamil. Requesting, pleading the child. Mother, intelligent mother, never beat the child. She handles carefully with love, compassion. She shows more care towards that child, a child who is naughty. That is why parents, I often say, a naughty child, hyperactive child, is nothing wrong if it is not active problem. Active is good. Therefore, your mind is also like a naughty child. Instead of drowsy, lazy, it is better. Let be active. Active mind. But at the same time, I have to handle like my child, my own child, how mother handles. On the other hand, suppose mother says, blaming the child, criticizing, telling to others, my child is like this, my child is like this. She's not supposed to say. She should take care of the child. She should embrace, encompass all his weaknesses in the baby, whatever she baby does, the child does. How motherly love, care is required for a child to bring up. Let us look at our mind also like a child. Innocent mind, ignorant mind, naughty mind, not listening to me. What to do? I have to address my mind. Oh mind, you are like a naughty child. Yetul orthone, that mother says, if you are behave like this, how can I bear? How can I bear? Mother feels inside, but she never scold the child. That is called matra, prema. Similarly, don't blame your own mind. Don't criticize your mind. Don't look down upon yourself. Every mind has got its own issues. Every mind has got its own likes and dislikes. Person to person it differs. But I have to be friendly with my own mind. Pooja Swami Dayananda Saraswati says, be friendly with your mind. Problem is you, solution is you, Swamiji says. Your vulnerable mind alone is your problem. Your positive mind, healthy mind, your own solution. Not knowing this fact, we always find others. No? Someone, because of you I am not happy, because of you I am not happy, you are only disturbing me. Nobody is disturbing us. Our own mind is disturbing us like a bug inside, and we are not able to handle. We are not able to handle. That mind is troubling me. Stress, depression, oppression, suppression, what not. Whole cyclone comes here only. That is why Chennai is not getting cyclone also. Because cyclone is coming in our minds in the form of stress, depression, all these problems. Why? Why it is coming? We are becoming more and more further sick and sick every day. Counselors are increasing day by day. It is the sign we are not able to handle our mind. That is why we ask parents, keep them in music class so they are free from counselors in future. Keep them in music class, dance class, somewhere. It makes the mind sane. Music has got such a power, wonderful power. Either instrument or a vocal or any other music, any dance form or any art, if they learn, they are sane. At the age of from 5 to between 15, that is the right age. So that mind, a naughty mind, a childlike mind, I have to take care of. He says, Manasa yetulurthuni, how can I bear you if you do like this? You are not listening to me. He's talking to his own mind. Manasa etulortune. I don't know why Tyagaraja felt like this, addressing his own mind. Manasa etulortune, how can I bear you? Na manavini, please listen my request. Please listen to me. Na manavini, cheyukonave. Not only listening, you have to implement. Our children, they listen, but they don't implement. You have to listen and implement. Na manavi vini chekonave anar. You have to implement. That means you have to give respect to my words. Not only listening, just listening, who wants? You have to put into practice. Manavi vini chekonave anar. What is my manavi? What is my request? Dinakara kula bhushanuni. Dinakara means the Lord Sun, Surya Vamsha, Kula, Bhushana. The Lord is like an ornament, Abharanam. Lord Rama is like an Abharanam for Surya Vamsha. Dinakara Kula Bhushanuni. Dinudarai Bhajanajes. Dinudavai Bhajanajai. You worship the Lord Rama, chant his name, sing about him. Rama, Rama, Rama. You go on, utter the name of that Rama. May you soak with like that pickle in Uppu is soaked. Wherever you touch that pickle, what you feel? What taste you feel? saltish. Like that, my mind has to fill with Rama, Rama, Rama. When Sita Devi gave that that mala, pearl chain to Hanuman as a gift, Hanuman started looking at where is Rama in any pearl. Rama appears. He go on taking one pearl and biting, then throwing. Then Sita saw, what is such a valuable pearl chain I have given? You are monkey buddhi, you have. That's why you are throwing. You do not know how to wear this chain. Then Hanuman said, no, Amma, I don't want this chain. Why you don't want? With so much love, I have given this chain to you. No, Amma, I don't want this because Rama is not there in that muttu. I want Rama. Where is Rama? Rama is in my heart. He showed. Sita, Rama, Lakshmana, Sameta sitting inside. So Anjaneya, Nanganallur Anjaneya is great, or Alvarpeta Anjaneya is great, or Mailapur Anjaneya is great. This is not bhakti. Anjaneya bhakti, Ram, 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 the whole body, each and every cell of Hanuman is Rama. That is called bhakti. Dina kara kula bhushanuni. Dinudavai bhajana jesi, worship that Rama. Bhajana jesi, spend your day. Dinamu gadupu manina neevu. Vinavadella, why you are not listening to me? I asked you to spend in japa, in puja, in parayanam. Going to temple, always spend that. You are not listening to me. And you are nodding head and after that you are going somewhere else. Vinavadella, why you are not listening to me? He is commanding his mind. You have to request your mind, you have to command your mind, you have to scold your mind in a smooth manner. Okay. You have to scold your mind. Sometimes that is also required. Vinavadella, why you are not listening to me? He is scolding Gunavihina. You don't have buddhi. You don't have head at all. Guna vihina. Vihina means without. You are not having, not listening my words which are valuable. Listen to me. How you can change yourself by Kalilo Rajasa Tamasa Gunamula Galavari Chilimikala Simila Sitirugaka. Underline that line. Oh mind, why you are moving like this? You are not listening to me, I know. You are not listening to me. You have bad friends. Now children, we ask now. You are not listening to me. That means you have someone guiding you, overpowering you, not listening to my words. Some children, adolescent children, they never care for their parents' words. They give importance to their friends' words. That is why parents are afraid of adolescent children. No? Very, very difficult to handle. Because they have the influence of outside friends. You also have that? He's asking his mind. He's asking, Kalilo Rajasa Tamasa Gunamula Galavari Chilimi Galasi Melasi Tirugaka. Don't move. Tirugaka, don't move. With whom? Kalasi Melasi. Don't move with them with the full, slow, closely. Slow, closely. Who are they? Tamasa Rajasa Gunamula Galavar. Those who are lazy. Those who are sluggish, lethargic, and those who are kavo, pivo, mazakaro, they are talking. Don't go with them. Those who are rajasic, hyperactive, always what? Workaholic, moneyholic. Money, 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 money. Don't go with them. Either money or lust or desires or entertainments or any luxuries. These rajasa, tamasa, guna people are not good. You don't move with them. See the words. Kalilo in Kali Yuga. Kali Yuga is especially Kalilo Rajasa Tamasa Gunamula Galavari Chilimi Galasi Melasi Tirugaka. Don't go with them. It is a lesson for us. By seeing your friend, your character can be judged. Who is your friend? By holding the book in your hand, what type of character yours we can know. If you carry star dust, some dust is there in Artham. If you carry Ramayana or Bharata, Bhagavata, you have a good character. Not only carrying, but You have to understand. That also important. Friends also with whom you are moving is very, very important. Therefore, choose friends who are sattvic. Don't move with rajasic, tamasic means what? Don't waste your time. Kalamu gadapakaye. Then what? Move with sattvic people, who are talking about God, who are talking about religion, who are talking about puja, who are talking about dharma, who are talking about all virtues, who are relaxed. If you talk with some people, you will be tensed. Don't go with those people. Your blood pressure will increase. Because they always talk about money, things, possessions. They never talk about God. Relaxation, you won't get it all. Therefore, our tension increases. Don't go with them. Sulabhamuga kadateranu. Be with sattvic people who are always good in nature. And sulabhamuga kadateranu. I will tell you what is the easy way. Kadateranu means to cross over this samsara to get moksha. Suchanalanu teliyajeyu. I am giving some suchanas, instructions to you. Don't move with the rajasic, tamasic people. This is my instruction to you. Move with only sattvic people. This is my instruction to you. Suchanalanu teliyajeyu. Vinavadella. Why you are not listening to me? Gunavihina. He says, Gunavihina. Why you are not listening? Please listen to me. So, this is really like pleading, requesting his own mind. So, our mind alone is Manasai Vedam Aptavyam. Through mind only you have to achieve even materialistic prosperity, even spiritual, anything. Mind, healthy mind is very important. Carnatic Sangeetam is that which makes your mind healthy. That too classical. Classical Carnatic. Carnatic is classical only, you know. Classical Carnatic Sangeetam with knowing the meaning, bhava. That bhava should come. You enjoy and transformation comes. Next. Manasu swadhina maina ya ghanunaku mari mantra tantra mulela. Now, after lot of instruction, mind has set right. This person is not leaving me. Therefore, I have to listen to him. Now, mind has come to some swadhina. Once swadhina comes, what next? You need not do anything. You relax. Like our Swamiji says always, you put a puri in oil, until it bulge, it moves round. Once it bulge up, it stops moving. In our life also like that. We always moving here and there, and once you know what is the truth, you know how to enjoy your inner leisure. You are with yourself. Nothing is required to be happy. Nothing is required. That is called world dependence to God dependence. God dependence alone is security. Let us listen to that.
manasu swadhina mainaya ghanunike manasu swadhina mainaya ghanunike manasu
Bye.